Hey guys, Lucas here. A couple hours from now, Hans Koenigsmann, the chief engineer from SpaceX, gave a little talk about SpaceX and their mission at the International Aeronautical Congress, this year held in Bremen, Germany. I was not there in person, but I paid for the live stream. I recorded it and will release it if I get permission to do so. Now, there was no really new information, which is typically reserved for Elon Musk, but I still want to highlight a couple details that were at least new and interesting to me. The talk was overall a presentation of what SpaceX is, what they have done so far, and what their future goals are. If you are a hardcore SpaceX fan that watches every video, reads every report,
like a monster rumba,
you are probably familiar with all of that already. Anyways, what I found out is Falcon Heavy will be able to put 15 metric tons to GTO in a fully expandable configuration. That is mostly limited by the upper stage, which is rather inefficient due to its kerosene fuel compared to other rockets. Koenigsmann also mentioned that engine efficiency is one part of the equation to increase the payload capability, and another is to just make it bigger, and that is of course what they'll do with BFR. But back to Falcon Heavy, landing on its boosters at sea, it would be still able to get 10 tons to GTO, which is in the order of what an Ariane 6 will be able to lift to. The normal configuration can get 8 metric tons to GTO when landing two boosters back at Cape and one at sea. There seems to be no plan to land all three back at Cape just yet, so a rapid reuse of the sender core within 24 hours seems unlikely, but who knows. Next is the new Dragon 2 crew capsule, which will land back at the East Coast, unlike Dragon 1, which currently lands on the Pacific Ocean to the west. He didn't give a reason for that, but it makes sense to land there since it will also launch from the East Coast. A rather speculative reason for me is, however, that the reentry will be seen across the US. People will be finally able to see Dragon returning home again, which is actually a huge deal in my opinion. One more cool thing to look forward to. The last part I want to mention in this video are the few questions Koenigsmann managed to answer. There was very little time, so please don't be disappointed if you're a little underwhelmed by that. The first question was, what are the main obstacles other than the gravity well for SpaceX? His answer? Well, there are no obstacles if they can continue to run their business as a real private company with fixed cost contracts and competition. This is what drives SpaceX. Their drive to innovate, it seems, would be lost or at least not the same without a competitive environment. To me, it feels like he tries to encourage other companies to follow their footsteps. Question 2 was about Block 5 and their experiences with it so far. Koenigsmann seemed extremely happy actually. He said he is surprised how well the engines keep up despite pointing them into the heat flow during re-entry. It's amazing, there are still some minor improvements to make, but he is overall incredibly satisfied with it. Next was a question about using kerosene on reusable engines. The background to this is kerosene does burn relatively dirty and can cloak up important parts like sensors and so on. His point of view is kerosene has its downsides, but it's cheap. It's easy to store and easy to develop engines for. Going forward, they will use methane on the upcoming Raptor engines, but it was definitely the right choice to start out with kerosene. I'm not sure if I get this correctly, but it could refer to Blue Origin, who started out with developing a hydrogen rocket. It took them extremely long to get it right, and their progress would have been surely much faster had they built New Shepard using kerosene. However, and that's just my opinion, now that they have a hydrogen rocket, they can use it as an upper stage and, at least in theory, outperform Falcon Heavy with their upcoming New Glenn rocket. This will be a very exciting competition, I think, and speaking of New Glenn, it recently got an updated look you can see here in this image. Question number 4 caused some confusion on stage because the guy was a little nervous, I think, but it came across after some back and forth. The BFR booster is said to use 31 engines according to the talk in 2017, and he wanted to know about the challenges in the design because while Falcon Heavy uses 27 engines, they are not mounted on the same platform. Having 31 attached to the same rocket could lead to some unknown difficulties. How does SpaceX make sure the BFR does not blow up, basically? Koenigsmann replied by just saying that SpaceX tests everything before they fly it, so we can look forward to see 31 Raptor engines firing all at once at that test site. This will of course require some huge fuel tanks and these engines will be incredibly hungry. He also said to mitigate some of the challenges, especially during startup, they will ignite them in sequences, which just means not all at once but in a manageable pattern. And the last question asked was about BFR or BFS reentry at Mach 30 from the moon, referring to the recent Dear Moon announcement I will cover in an upcoming video. I still haven't really digested that one, to be honest. It's crazy, but I love it. Anyways, Koenigsmann's answer was that what really counts, or where the true challenge lies, is the heat flow and not so much the speed. The speed itself does not increase the difficulty so much, if at all, when I understand correctly. So, to make sure BFS is fine, they will start out with a lot of heat shielding and trim it down as they gain experience. I really think that is the essence of what makes SpaceX so efficient as a company. Just do it and learn how you can improve on it by actually putting it to the test. Okay, that shall conclude this little overview, and feel free to check my Twitter thread where I covered the event live. I will link it below. Auf Wiedersehen and thank you for watching.